Bishop Eddie Long knew that he was destined to be the pastor of a large church. He just didn't know how large, but he soon found out. Watch this.
Bishop Eddie Long is the pastor of New Birth Missionary Church in Georgia. When he started as a pastor, there were 300 members. Soon, church membership exploded.
He's keeping you for something big!
Now, New Birth has over 25,000 members, and its services are broadcast all over the country. Bishop Long wants you to know how you can live your life to the fullest in every area. His new book, 60 Seconds to Greatness, tells you how to seize the moment and follow God's plan for your life.
His book is called 60 Seconds to Greatness, Seize the Moment and Plan for Success. Here's a man who knows what he's talking about. It's a pleasure to welcome to the 700 Club a dear friend, Bishop Eddie Long. Eddie,
thank you. God, thank you so much. Honored to be here.
Thank you.
Great being here.
You've got that marvelous church down in Atlanta, that wonderful campus. And did you always start that way? Did you think it was going to be something that big?
No, I was somewhat frustrated at one time. I was over 30 years old, and yeah. I knew I was going to pastor a large church, but at the time, I thought large was going to be like 1,500 people. Yeah. And I was telling God, you need to hurry up, because to get 1,500 people is going to take a lifetime. Yeah. And then for the way God has done tremendously, abundantly above all I could ask or think.
We got 35,000.
It's close to that.
Close to that?
Yes.
What's the secret?
It's just God. It's God. And I think when you start dealing with real things people are dealing with, and being transparent, yeah. letting them know, you know, I struggle with this too, you know, but this is what the Lord says. And using, you know, I used to use books with examples in it, et cetera, to get my point across, but God gave me a family and myself, and that's what I talk
about. You're using your own examples. That's kind of hard to be open up. And they say open kimonos, you're showing them. Well, your book is called 60 Seconds to Greatness, and what does that title mean?
It really means that you maximize the moment, Pat. You really have to take and make a decision. I'm here at Regions, here at the studio, et cetera, and I can look at certain points. You made a decision to captivate the moment. God is always in the now. Mm-hmm. And when you grab the opportunity of that moment, of that now, and train yourself that all I have is a minute and everything that's in it. And so when I start moving in that moment and not be paralyzed by mm-hmm. the past or too anxious about what's going to happen and where you're going in the future, you are able to maximize the moment, because that's where God is, in the present.
Right in the present.
Right in the
present. What about the vision that the Lord has given you?
Well, I even talk about 60 seconds to vision, and really, I'm talking about Habakkuk and how Habakkuk says, I will set myself up. I had challenges. I got problems. Why is the righteous prospering? Why are wicked nations doing all these things? It doesn't seem like you're bringing them into judgment. A lot of us have questions to God. Why is this happening? Why is that happening? But Habakkuk said this for a vision. He said, I will set myself up and see what the Lord says when he speaks to me, which means I got confidence God's going to speak to me. Mm-hmm. And so everybody, when they put themselves in position for God to speak to you, God will speak. But the wonderful thing he said after that, he said, and when I am corrected, which means, Lord, I know you're not wrong. Mm-hmm. There's some way I'm looking at this thing that I need an adjustment, and I'm teachable. And Lord, I'm opening myself up for you to correct me, teach me, show me the right way, and then Lord infuses vision to you.
Those 5 points you bring out in your book, you know, 5 key points about vision, are they the ones taken from Habakkuk?
Yeah, they were taken from Habakkuk because it's at an appointed time. And then it talks about that it will speak. And not only will it speak, it will not lie. And though it not lie, then it will not tarry, because that vision will not be delayed. And so when you move in that process and know that it is for an appointed time, it is for God will not lie. He will speak, and you can stand on that. If God said it, he shall perform it. Amen. And he sent a blessing to us that he cannot revoke it. And so when you hold on to those things, I think at a time where you see so much by sight, mm-hmm. if you walk with a vision, they said people without a vision will perish. It's really, as you know, talking about without a divine revelation of who he is.
Yes.
And when you get a divine revelation of who he is, then you can trust him. And regardless of what I see, I'm not walking by sight. I am walking by my faith in what I heard God speak to me.
What about that strategic life plan for your members? You tell each one to have a strategic
life. Yeah, well, before the recession that God gave me this to speak to my members, and, you know, we are on Streaming Faith and we speak around the world, we put together a strategic life plan outline so you can start planning in reference to your family, your personal growth, your personal life, in reference to health and fitness, how you eat. You know, Pat, we do a lot. You know, God has kept you well for all these years, et cetera. It's because you take care of your temple. Mm-hmm. You take care of, you eat right. It's just not by accident. Sometimes you do a homegoing or funeral service and say, the Lord decided to take them home. No, they ate themselves to death. They did not exercise. They did not do this.
Yeah, so. You don't tell the family that.
You don't tell. It's really, but in reality, when I'm not in it, you really have to strategic. God is so strategic. That's why he gave us the blueprint, those 66 bullets of the Bible. It's just, there's a way that God has ordained for us. Mm-hmm. And he wants us to plan out our lives strategically. And then, like Rebecca, no, I have to make certain adjustments. But I need to have a plan for my life, a plan for my family, a plan for my finance, a plan for my children, for my bloodline, because I identify myself as a God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, which means I am generational. Okay. That's the reason why the book is so important, 60 Seconds of Greatness, because you're making a decision not only for your personal life, you're making a decision for your bloodline. You're making a decision for your community. Mm-hmm. You're making a personal decision to better your church because you become better in the mission of God.
I ask you the last question. Well, what about the church itself? That thing is enormous. I mean, folks, if you've ever been down there, I mean, it is gigantic. It's this wonderful campus that Eddie's built in that wonderful church. What do you got planned? Is this the end of the line? Is there more coming?
Yeah, well, we're doing like you, and I took a tour of the studio, just making sure that we take full advantage of using all the modern technology to get the gospel out and to be able to be relevant to a society that's having various challenges, et cetera, and have to first know that you understand where they are and meet them where they are and then show them where God wants them to be. So aggressively getting out in the community more, and, you know, we're doing a lot of work in Africa and around the world, New Zealand and that, and really touching lives to affect the culture.
Well, I know that vision the Lord has is not going to be delayed. Eddie Long is going to have it. 60 Seconds to Greatness is this book. It's available where books are sold. Yes? Everywhere?
Yes. Everywhere.
And a tremendous book by an extraordinary pastor of an extraordinary church. If any of you live in the Atlanta area, you go by and where's your church is?
It's actually about 15 minutes east of downtown Atlanta. Just go out 20 east. It's actually in lovely Lathonia, Georgia.
Lathonia, you can't miss it. Eddie, thank you so much for being here.
God bless you.
God bless you, my brother.